Welcome to the O-PitDev live demo in a quarry. Over here we have our military grade case. We also have a QR code that gives you access to the manual of the O-PitDev. And now let's open up this case to see the goodies that we brought with us. So, as you see, we have over here the probe, O-PitDev, our probe developed by us. Inside we have grease as well for O-rings, the manual, some carabiners, pens, chargers for car, for USB, armband as well. So the O-PitDev, as you probably know, it can be used by only one person. So the armband is really useful. A towel to clean up. Now let's go to the field and do some testing. Over here, we are in a quarry. Not every time the best conditions are applied in a quarry, so you need to act and take precaution. We have a tube, okay? This tube is to prevent rock to fall into the borehole. To avoid that, we put this tube. Now, over here we have our app. This is an app to measure that is exclusively for the O-PitDev. In order to connect to the probe, what you need to do? First, you need to shake it and the LED will turn red. Then, over here, you need to connect first the Bluetooth and the localization, the GPS. Then open up the O-PitDev app and you'll see in the hamburger menu the select probe. Simply open up, wait a little bit until it appears there. Now you see the dev, you simply press it and now you are connected to it. Let me just turn on the data. As you see over there in the top right corner on the phone, you'll see the battery. So you can check the battery for the O-PitDev. The green LED shows that it's connected to the phone. So as you see here, now let's calibrate the probe. So again, hamburger menu, and you go to calibration screen. To calibrate the magnetometer, it's simply doing a figure of eight, okay? Just like this. And you'll see that the magnetometer will be calibrated. The gyro is basically to hold still in a flat platform like this. More or less 10 seconds is enough. You can get over here in the app a correct sign that is showing that it's okay. And now for the accelerometer, you simply just take it, hold it, wait a little bit, more or less 10 seconds between moves, and until the accelerometer is calibrated. Change up, wait a little bit more, because of course this is doing, this calibration, it needs to be done in field. Guys, every time you go to the field, arrive in the field, you need to be doing this calibration. As you see, it's really simple. It doesn't take you too much time. It's really simple to calibrate the probe. Simply doing this, you take up 1.5 minutes, and that's it. As you see here on the screen, everything has the right. Now let's save the calibration, and now the dev is calibrated. Let's go back. We go back to my files, and now let's scroll to our project for this purpose. So we have over here O-PitDev webinar. As you saw there, you can use work online, offline, or local. The dev is independent from the O-PitBlast software, so you can work only with the dev. But of course, if you have both, it communicates together, so you have all of there already your blast online. Let's open up. I have some boreholes. Open up one. You can see the information regarding the blast. So the planet values, of course, this is just some values standardized, and you can edit them. So double press there and you can enter the value that you plan with. The angle, azimuth, length, you choose the survey. So you can survey the step between 1 and 1 meter, 2 and 2, or 3 and 3. In this case, we'll be doing 1 and 1. Then the offset that I will explain a little bit later. And basically, this is the app. Now I'll gear up. We have our armband, some gloves, and a pen, a touch pen, in order to click the O-PitDev. You take a look and it's blue. Okay, that means that it's in survey mode. Now let's start. The method choose was downhole, so first let's drop it down the first meter. You need to stop 1 meter in the collar. So let's stop over here more or less in the collar and press measure. The phone will beep and vibrate. When it's finished, you need to lower. 0.5 meter and 2 meters. And start measuring again. another meter, measure it. Good practice. You need to stay steady, okay? Try to stay maintain the probe the most steady as possible and start simply measuring the borehole. 4 meters, a half. Let's go to the 5. Top. You notice by the beeps, another meter. 7, 8. You see in the app as well, you have some options that you can undo and restart. So imagine for some reason you feel like a little bit shaky or something, you can undo the last measurement. And we hit bottom. So as you see here, it's on more or less on the 10 meters, okay? So it's according to the offset in 1 and 1 meter will be 0 because the next measurement is 10, so the offset is 0. So let's measure it. But let's imagine that for some reason the offset is like here, okay? So the offset is the distance between the collar to the next available measurement. So for example, over here, you notice like is 9.5, okay? The distance until the 10 meters is 0.5. Let's take it off. You finish the borehole. Now, the probe is outside. What you need to do is start, press end, and insert again the offset. Again, the offset was 0. If it was 1.5, 0.5, 0.6, you can write it down what you want. And you simply press OK. The probe is connecting to the phone to get the information back. As you see here, we have the real results. So 10 meters, angle 16.6, and the azimuth 7.98, okay? You can write it down some comments, and you can go to the 2D view and see, for example, the deviation from the side, from the back, top, and a resume with all the measurements. And it's simple, then afterwards you need to start measuring the other boreholes. Okay. You go back, and on the top right corner you have a 3 dots that you can automatically generate the report. So you press generate report and you have a ready to print report from the O-PitDev. Or if you want, you can share it between WhatsApp and so on with a different file extension, RHD, DAT, CSV, and so on. Basically, you can set magnetic correction. After that, you are ready to import this data into O-PitBlast and see the 3D on the software to put a better charge, to do deck charging, and so on, to correct, for example, the burden critical to the free face, and to see all of that information to have a better blast and to avoid safety issues such as fly rocks, boulders, fines, and so on. Thank you so much.